the full lineup. It is a mouth-watering 5,000 meters. Vivian Cheruiyot, who has finished behind these two on numerous occasions. Abi Laghessi, who took the silver medal in the 10,000 meters behind Dibaba. Melkemu, the third of the Ethiopians. Shabukova, the new European champion over 5,000 meters. Galkina Samidova, a gold medal and a world record in the 3,000 meter steeplechase. Sylvia Kibet of Kenya. Bekele, not related to the famous ones, but running for Turkey here, former Ethiopian. There's a Chinese athlete in there as well, Xue Fei. Jen Rhines for the United States, Megan Metcalf of Canada. Defar, we saw Cara Goucher, medalist from the World Championships last year, and the very experienced Prisca Chirono for Kenya. You really would go down that whole list there, and all of the athletes, you could put a kind of line against them, whether it's world titles, Olympic titles, all the way down to, we've got medalists here from multiple events, as I've already mentioned, record holders. It is a stellar lineup here in this women's 5,000 meters. The only individual event on the track here in the Bird's Nest this evening, but I'm sure this will be one to savor. The three medalists from the 10,000 meters, how will they come back and cope? Defar, fresh, the event at which she is the defending champion. She'll be the first person to defend this title. Of course, they've only been running 5,000 meters since 1996. It was 3,000 meters a couple of Olympic Games before that, back in 84 when they first started running proper distance events for women. It's only been done by a few men, you know, doing the double as well. We'll come to Dibaba in a second. That's Cara Goucher. And of course, she saw Shalane Flanagan, who's on the inside in this race. Shalane Flanagan tipped the bronze medal here. She took the bronze medal in the World Championships last year. The 10,000 meters, Americans very strong. Well, Kenya, of course, have had to watch all the time as the Ethiopians have taken the medals, both in the men's distance event and in the women's. Although they have struck gold here, Jalimo taking the 800 meter title, the first Kenyan woman to win the Olympic gold medal. One of the most eagerly awaited races of these Olympic Games. Defar versus Dibaba, world record holders, European champions and Olympic medalists thrown in almost as bit part players, but I'm sure one or two of them might have something to say in how this race has run as well. It won't just be about the two big names, but you get the feeling that when we get to the bell lap, we'll be talking about those two. Well, I was mentioning Dibaba, Bren, and you know what it's like to run both races in Olympic Games. There's no woman, obviously, has run the double so far. There aren't that many men over the years. Some have tried. Of course, Mirza Yifta, the last one to do it. Viren did it twice when you were around. The likes of Kutz and Zatopek. And then you have to go all the way back to Kolomine. And even the great Pavel Nurmi never managed to do two in the same games. It's a tough task to come back after you've run one long race already.
It certainly is a tough task. The great Haile Gebrselassie couldn't make it. He couldn't even get to the start of the 5,000 metres after he won the 10,000 metres. His feet were so bad. And last time around, that classic race we had in the Olympic Games in Athens, El Garouj coming on top, and Kenenisa Bekele unable to do the 10,000 metre, 5,000 metre double. Can Tirunesh Dibaba become the first woman to win the 10,000 metre, 5,000 metre double? Can Defar become the first woman to retain the title? And the race, the rest of them seem preoccupied with the fact that Defar and Dibaba are in the race and they're actually just jogging around.
That might have been an Olympic record, because in 2004 they ran 81 seconds for the first lap and we've had almost identical. I made that about 81.76. That might be a record. What do you think?
Well, I'll tell you what, it might have been a record if you could have done it these days, Steve, but we'll move on from there. But yeah, 81 seconds, I'd be proud of that, would you?
Mark Butler's just said 82.6. I'm useless timekeeper. It's interesting, isn't it? That's exactly what happened 4 years ago. And you've got some front runners in here, the likes of Abi Laghessi. You can just see her at the back there with the number three on her shorts in red from Turkey, who tried to really take the race to Dibaba. And that full lap, so they actually they started a bit quicker. So the lap since they've come through the finish line in almost 90 seconds. Now, that's 6-minute miling, Brendan. I have to tell you, I can still run 6-minute miling.
Well, you know, this reminds me of the, you know, those bicycle races when they sit on the start and get ready to make the move and all that sort of thing. It's just like this. It's like the slow bicycle race, Steve.
A bicycle race. A bicycle. Yeah, I know what you mean. Anyway. Okay, well, this race yet to get underway, but it's just almost teasing us, really, for what's yet to come. Galkina Samitova, the Russian there, you saw just on the shoulder of Vivian Cheruiyot, is a committed front runner, and she must be just itching to go to the front here. But of course, she ran a world record in the steeplechase, did it all by herself, pretty much gun to tape, and did a similar thing in the heats to qualify for this 5,000 metres. But at the moment, no interest whatsoever in getting this final moving. And this, it starts to get dangerous though, Bren, then, because you click off 2, 3, 4 laps just jogging, and of course that then just reduces it to, first of all, a 3,000 metre race, and then after that, who knows, it might get even less.
Well, the whole event, this 5,000 metre event, is all going to be about the tactics. Now, the three Kenyans, the three Ethiopians, there's three Americans, and there's two Russians, and clearly, from what we've seen so far, 3 minutes 39 for the first 1,000 metres. Well, I would like to work it out quickly. I don't even think that's very good marathon running pace, but it doesn't make any difference. There's no prizes for time. We are being a bit humorous about this, but it's not about that. It's about who's going to hold the nerve, who's going to keep their concentration, who's going to get overawed by the occasion. Because when you're running in the Olympic Games and the race is going as slowly as this, the nerves are still working. Whereas if you run a fast race in an event like this, then you're applying your physical ability, and your mental toughness and strength goes out of the window when you start to become tired. But when you're jogging around, you're looking around, seeing what's going on, you're just biding your time, you're hoping somebody's going to make a move. And the tactical bit here is to me, is fascinating.
Well, in all of the races I've commentated on over a few years now, I've never seen anything, I don't think, as slow as this. I remember the World Championship men's 5,000 metre race being very slow for 3 or 4 laps a few years ago, the one where Craig Mottram took the bronze, but it got moving and at least decent running. But this is not even that thing. You start to feel uncomfortable, and there you go, Abby Ligesi's had enough. It's just silly, to be honest, and she's obviously a 10,000 metre exponent as well. She knows what will happen in the latter stages, and there are medals here, of course. We talk about Defan de Barba, the others, well, they won't give it to them easily, but they'll also be thinking there's a chance for any one of us here to take a bronze medal. And finally, this women's 5,000 metre final gets underway.
9 laps to go, and suddenly Abby Ligesi is the first one to break and decide that she's not happy running a 90-second pace for each lap, and she's decided to try and turn it into a proper race. The result, well, the first part of it clearly makes no difference, makes no impact, but if they run 9 hard laps, I figure you'll get the same sort of result as if you run 12 and a half hard laps. Abby Ligesi ran that 10,000 metres, really pushed Tirunesh de Barba all the way in the 10,000 metres, and now she's decided that she wants to make them run for this one. She wants to make them fight for the title. In there, in second place, the reigning champion, just behind her, Galkina Samitova, the steeplechase champion, and just behind her, in sixth place, the smooth-looking figure of Tirunesh de Barba, the 10,000-metre champion. Looking up at the screen just to see what's going on around her, they're very aware of everything these days, and now the race is suddenly stretched and gaps begin to open.
Well, that obviously was the fastest lap so far, 67 seconds, and that's more like it. I mean, if they'd run the whole race like that, that's almost world record pace, but they're not. And two women in this field, well, actually, Abby Ligesi held the world record not that long ago, ran in Bergen in Norway, and then last year I remember watching Defar in Oslo break the world record, and then this year it was de Barba's turn to run just a stunning race where she really picked it up last 4 or 5 laps by herself. And Defar went to Stockholm just not long before these Beijing games and tried to attack that record herself. Finished just over a second outside, and you know, when she crossed the line in Stockholm, she burst into tears. And it's the first time I've really seen any of the Ethiopians show that sort of emotion. It meant so much to try and take that record back from de Barba. Brent talked about the rivalry that the two of them have. And I think that meant a lot to Defar that she wasn't able to do it. And the one thing she can't do here is let any of that sort of emotion get into this. I talked about their win-loss record. Defar has had the better of it, particularly in bigger races. The first time the two of them raced each other was back in 2002 in the World Junior Championships. Defar came out on top that time. De Barber was second, and incidentally, Vivian Cheruiyot, who's in this race as well, was third on that occasion. The three of them have moved through the senior ranks as we just see the first of the athletes start to fall off the back. Shalane Flanagan will undoubtedly be tired after her exploits in the 10,000 metres. Just a little gap appearing there. But as I said, Brent, Defar and De Barber, their rivalry is strong. But when it comes to that last lap, you know, you just feel as though sometimes Defar has always had a little bit of an Indian sign over De Barber. But recently, De Barber's been able to turn that around.
Well, Defar's a couple of years older than De Barber. When De Barber won a medal last Olympic Games, she was the youngest female medalist. Female distance runner to win a medal. Samitova just moving along there. Now they've settled down and they've slowed down again. Abby Legesi did a little bit, but didn't want to do very much more. At that point, Cara Goucher moving up on the outside from America. She sensed the pace was slowing, and I think she'd like a true run race. She's more of a long distance runner, 5,000 meters, 10,000 meters, and we saw her last year, number 3171, win the Great North Run, a half marathon, where she beat Paula Radcliffe. She's planning to do the same sort of thing again this year, but this race, I would have thought she would be more pleased if she came off the track having run hard all the way and tried to run a good, consistent pace. But now, once again, the field slows down, concertinas together, and there's no reason why Galkina Samitova, the leader, should be doing other than just taking it at her own pace. So, a technical race, there'll be lots of discussions afterwards. Why didn't you do this? Why didn't you do that? But it's about decision-making. It's about holding your nerve. Cara Goucher on the shoulder of Samitova. And again, when the race slows like this, it's who's going to make a move, who's going to get ready, who's going to do something.
You know, I think one of the reasons we're seeing this is there aren't many, I don't think many women in this race who actually are trying to win this race, quite obviously, because they're assuming, they're making assumptions, as you naturally would, that Defar and De Barber are going to have it all to themselves on the last lap. And so no one's trying to win it here. They're all running for the bits at the end.
I think the other thing, Steve, which I think is relevant these days, is when they run on the circuit, they run in races where they've got pacemakers taking them lap after lap after lap, and they're just running in a metronomic manner. They don't have to worry about setting the race and racing themselves. So some of these athletes are more used to being following and being running in race with pacemakers than they are running in competitive races. This is a truly competitive race. 9:58 for 3,000 metres, 81 seconds for that lap, and seriously, with five laps to go, it's a 2,000 metre race. It's going to bring some of the athletes into the reckoning. It's not a true run distance race. It's a shorter, fast race, but you can sense that the pace is about to get ready to move again.
Okay, let's go down the line a little here. Galkina Samitova still leading. Cara Goucher's on her shoulder, although Chirono just moves up, as I say that, and Kibet just watches on the inside. Goucher responds as well. Then we've got De Barber, Abby Legesi, but the other Turkish athlete, Bekele, Shabakova, the other Russian, just been hovering all the time. She might be a danger at the end as well. Then the other two Ethiopians towards the back. Just almost takes a tumble there and just checks who it was behind her. It always happens, it can happen very, very easily indeed.
That's what happens in races like this, that's what happens when they bunch. They're all looking up at the screen, which actually takes their eyes off what's happening right in front of them. But there's no point in looking up at the screen, there's nothing to see. All you're going to see is that the whole field, almost the whole field, are running together. Less than four laps to go in the women's 5,000 metre race. It's not a 5,000 metre race anymore. It's heading to be more like a 1,500-metre race. And if it was a 1,500-metre race, you might get a slightly different result. Now, somebody is going to have to make a move and try and pick the pace up and try and make the later stages tell. And it looks like Tirunesh De Barber, the 10,000-metre champion, the athlete who's renowned with her sprint finish, she's the first one to make a positive move towards the later stage of the race. But again, it's not a real move, it's only getting herself in a position. And you notice Defar, soon as she saw De Barber move, she went right on her shoulder, right behind her, and she's tracking her. Now that's where she'd like to be, waiting and waiting and waiting.
Bekele of Turkey, former Ethiopian as well, just in the red, just moves up into third spot there. Melkemu moving around, and Defar's going to have to come wide. She lost her position, as Brendan was saying. It was interesting because I think Abby Lagesse was thinking about pushing it on, and just as she moved around the outside on the back straight there, we had the move from DeBarber, and Abby Lagesse thought better of it, but actually, as Brent said, DeBarber didn't actually do anything. So it's the Russian in the front now, Galkina Semidova, the gold medalist in the steeplechase, as they, for the first time, really start to stride out now. There's just over 1,000 metres to go in this, and it's interesting to me that DeBarber feels as though she wants to be in the front and controlling it, that perhaps she wants to attack a little bit earlier than she normally does with Defar. Not going to sit behind her teammate. Defar is the one who's playing the head waiter at the moment, watching DeBarber right in front of her. But the whole field here still involved, and for the first time now, DeBarber feeling as though she wants to get this moving. There's another push from behind as Abby Lagesse comes out and looks for room, and Abby Lagesse wants to get on with it as they come down with two laps to go.
It's a strange race these athletes are in, an event in a manner of this event is something that's never happened to these athletes before, and it's about who's going to keep their mental control and toughness, who's prepared now to run an 800 meters faster than they've ever run before at the end of a pedestrian 5,000 meters, but at the end of it you get the same prize as if you run a full flat out race and a world record. The world record holder in second place, the champion from the 10,000 meters is there. Just on the inside, Mel Karmu, the third string Ethiopian athlete. And now they're operating and striding down the back straight. Abby Lagesse is stretching them. Defar is moving up on the shoulder of Tirunesh DeBarber. And who's going to make the first serious move? 600 meters to go, and this race is anybody's, really.
Abby Lagesse finds the Ethiopian sitting on her shoulder. It's a familiar position she finds herself in. DeBarber, Melkamo on the inside, Defar following DeBarber, wants to be as close as she can when the strike comes, and for the first time DeBarber puts her foot down, but it's not decisive yet. This is just the first kick, there'll be more to come, rest assured of that. And two of the Kenyans go with it, Kibet and Chirono, and Shabukova, the Russian, is in there also.
The bell sounds, Tirunesh DeBarber, the 10,000 metre gold medalist in the front, the Olympic champion, following her on the shoulder, that's Defar. Now, who's got the sprint finish? We're going to have to see one of the fastest last laps we've ever seen in a women's distance race, because to get rid of Abby Lagesse, they're going to have to run close to 58 seconds or better. Tirunesh DeBarber stretching, Defar's just waiting, Abby Lagesse's coming under pressure, the gaps are opening. Is the 10,000 metre champion to become the 5,000 metre champion, or is Defar going to reign again? But there goes DeBarber.
And DeBarber kicks away from the front. Defar had no response, although she's coming again as Abby Lagesse goes past her. But DeBarber is away and gone. She's got a 5 metre lead. The woman who took the gold medal in the 10,000 metres, heading for home in the 5,000 metres. It will be an historic double for Tirunesh DeBarber, the double Olympic champion, streaking away to win for Ethiopia again. Abby Lagesse takes the silver, Defar the bronze. It was a strange, strange race. And Defar congratulates DeBarber, who had the confidence and the ability. I'm not sure that she thought that Defar would be as easy to beat on the last lap as that. She went for the long run from home at the bell and just turned on the pressure all the way around that last lap. DeBarber makes history for Ethiopia again.
A fantastic performance by Tirunesh DeBarber, a disappointing race, but the prize is hers. And tonight in Meskel Square, in the middle of Addis Ababa, when the big screens are erected, they'll be going absolutely wild. They've seen the champion of the 10,000 metres win the 5,000 metres. 28 years ago, the great Miritz Yifter won the 10,000, 5,000 double in the Olympic Games in Moscow, and here we are. Here's Tirunesh DeBarber, tracked all the way by Defar, and coming down the home straight. She looked up at the screen. She's working hard now. They're all working hard. The last 200 meters is being run in 30 seconds. So that's why you can tell the little gaps are opening and they're stretching. But she's timed it brilliantly. She's made her move. And now the rest of them have got to pass her when she's operating at 59-second pace for the last lap. 30 seconds for the last 200 metres, 59.5 for the last lap, timed by Mark Butler, our statistician. And so you can see, they can't get on terms. When an athlete's in full flow, you sense She's dragging it out of them. But here they are, coming up to the 200-meter point. Tirunesh Dibaba sprints again, and there Defar finally relents, finally gives up on the chase of defending her 5,000-meter title. The silver medalist from the 10,000 meters struggles to pass Meseret Defar into the straight, and there Tirunesh Dibaba, she's looked over the screen, she knows it's a winning gap, she knows she just has to keep going, and a fantastic performance by the 22-year-old. Four times world champion, three times world cross-country champion, and now the Olympic 10,000 meters and 5,000 meter double. This lady is already one of the greatest distance runners of all time. Two gold medals in the Olympic Games here to add to her already fantastic collection. She's 22 years of age. In London, she'll be approaching her peak in 2012, and that's something to savor and to look forward to. What a phenomenal distance runner, what a phenomenal performer in a very, very strange race. The time was miles outside of her personal best, but that was a glorious victory, and that's all that matters. Abi Laghessi in second, Defar in third.
Well, more medals for Ethiopia to celebrate. I'm not sure Defar was at her best there. Brendan was saying that 59 last lap or so, and I think Defar at her best might have put more pressure on Dibaba. Might not have got past her, but would have put more pressure on it. And let's hand it to Abi Laghessi as well. It's been a good games for her. Two silver medals, both of them, of course, behind Tirunesh Dibaba. First really came to prominence as a junior when she won that first world title in 2003 in Paris, and as Brent said, still only 22 years of age. Kenenisa Bekele will be hoping that he can do the same, of course, in the men's event tomorrow, the men's 5,000 metres. So a disappointing race in the end, but not for Dibaba. The time absolutely irrelevant. Gold medal for Ethiopia, silver to Abi Laghessi again, and Defar having to settle for the bronze.